copper, zinc, and it was determined that the combination of 80% copper and 20% tin produced the best sound.
The bell was made the same way bells have been made since the Middle Ages. Molten bronze was poured into a mold. But pouring metal for a bell this large presented a daunting new challenge.
We had about 80,000 pounds of metal ready to be poured. We calculated it had to be done in 4 minutes and 54 seconds. If it was too slow, we'd end up like the Liberty Bell in Philadelphia. If it didn't cool uniformly, the danger would be that the bell would crack the first time it would hit, because the metal would be inconsistent. The final cooling stage would be inconsistent.
The bell's designers from Bird and Bells in Cincinnati, Ohio, held their breath the first time the switch was thrown to release the striking hammer.